It's a little bit different to our standard V6 guitar, but you can all tell what it's supposed to be based on. And it's got an American alder body, so we're actually importing American hardwoods to the Far East for them to build the guitars with. It's got a set of matched calibrated pickups designed by Trevor Wilkinson, proper Alnico V single coils, so we've got a real sort of vintage tone. You get all the noises you'd expect to get when you're calibrated and balanced to work together, which I don't think a lot of other companies are doing, especially not this price point, which is about £280. Original, everybody calls them either whammies or tremolos or whatever, but the reason why they got called a tremolo in the early days is because the word vibrato had been painted on another device, I think it was on an effects pedal. So when Leo Fender created the vibrato for the original guitars, he couldn't actually use that word, so he ended up calling it a tremolo, but it's not tremolo. What tremolo is a variation in volume, so that's tremolo. But what this does is it raises or lowers the pitch, and that's vibrato. He expected people to use it very sort of gently, sort of more for a gentle effect like that. And of course you hear that sort of usage in sort of like early Shadows stuff. Very sort of subtle usage, but very effective. But then of course again to the 70s, we're going to the 80s, and guitarists are getting a little bit more adventurous, a little bit more standard vibrato like this on another guitar, it'd be way out of tune now. You wouldn't be able to do that. The string stretching and pulling would have meant that you'd have had at least two or three strings out of tune.
It's not a locking tremolo, is it?
It's not a locking tremolo, no. No, it's not. And it's brilliant. But what are the innovations by other people making sort of locking clamps and things like this? Trevor's come up with this fantastic little idea, and basically it's in the machine head. Each of these posts has got two holes. So you put the string in the first hole and then into the second hole, then wind it up. Now basically, as long as you stretch your strings in properly when you've put them on, you'll have no problems with your tuning. No matter how abusive you get with that. And best of all, when you change your strings, you don't need to have a garage, you know, and strange clamps to take off. It's a proper solid steel block on there as well on the vibrato, which is important for tone. Won't sound right if it's anything else. And bent steel saddles as well, again, very important. Now this is a slightly different take on the standard V6. Of course, you probably noticed it's got the reverse headstock. We call it the Fillmore model. So it's kind of a sort of tacit nod towards that fantastic icon of the electric guitar. We've kept it a right-handed body simply because it's going to appeal more that way to the majority of people, and it's also more comfortable to play that way. If you've ever tried to play a left-handed guitar right-handed, you'll know that all these are in the way and the vibrato's in the way, and it's amazing that Hendrix managed to do what he did with all those things holding him back. One thing that Trev's done, he thinks is very important, is he's reversed the positioning of that pickup, as it would be if he'd flipped a guitar over, because he's actually certain that that had a lot to do with the tone. Sounds like we're going to swarm a bee, isn't it?
Oh, sorry.
There we go. I'm thinking the effects pedals are playing. There's something not right, yeah. So we've got the pickup reverse, so it's like exactly how Jimmy's would have been, with the treble side further away from the bridge than normal.